at SportsZone123.com and on the SportsZone Radio smartphone app. And now, it's time for Northland Basketball.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back into Northland Basketball for two final broadcasts of this entire 2022 and 23 basketball season. Out on the floor, the starting lineup is being announced for one of the participants in this year's 3A State Girls Championship game. That team, that's the Alchesay Lady Falcons. The higher seed, believe this or not, in this championship game are the Sholo Lady Cougars, and they're about to get introduced by today's public address announcer, the great Jim Barnett, the voice of the Arizona Interscholastic Association Championships. And it's a championship Saturday in downtown Phoenix, everybody. Let's turn it over to our public address announcer.
Sophomore number 25, Ramona Gray. Junior number 30, Alyssa Jim. Sophomore number 32, Alina Henry. And junior number 42, Abby Jim. Now here's the starting lineup for Alchesay. Starting at guard, a senior, number one, Jalen Mashier. At forward, a senior, number two, Jenneth Sanchez. At guard, a senior, number three, Cheyenne Massey. Guard, a junior number five, Jaslyn Nolsey. And a forward, a junior number 15, Cameron Nakshu. Assistant coaches, Crystal DeClay and Naomi LeFay, with head coach, Rick Sanchez. Now let's meet the Sholo Cougars. Freshman number five, Jordan Boyce. Freshman number 14, Jay Lee Boyce. Junior number 20, Amberlyn Lindsay. Junior number 21, Grace Moore. Freshman number 22, Tatum Moore. Junior number 23, Sydney Stahl. And senior number 24, Addison Cotterman. Now here's the starting lineup for the Cougars. Starting at guard, a sophomore, number 10, Raquel Wilson. And guard, a senior, number 12, Alex Swanson. At guard, a junior, number 13, Mackenzie Coolidge. Starting at forward, a junior, number 30, Aubrey Wilson. And at forward, a senior, number 40, Sadie Hall. Assistant coaches, Dave Borden and Jackie Teagle, with head coach, Christy Francis. Ladies and gentlemen, the game officials for this game were assigned by the AIA Commissioner of Officials, Brian Gessner, and the Assistant Commissioner, Jeannie Cosselworth. They are Andy Goodman, Ani Bayardo, and Tony Gutierrez. The alternate official is George Brown.
So the now starting lineups announced for tonight's matchup in the 2023 Arizona Interscholastic Association 3A State Championship game, and it's time now for the national anthem. always one of my favorite renditions of the national anthem. I believe they're called the Gaither Vocal Band. And it's a standard for sure as we get ready to go on a championship broadcast here at the Sports Zone. My name is Floyd Simmons. Welcome in, everybody. And the Alchesay fans, they are on fire. They're going for it. They are already intense. And we're about ready to tip this one up and get it underway, everybody. Thanks for joining us for Northland Basketball at the Sports Zone. This is broadcast number 96 of the season for us. Yes, the 96th game that we will have broadcast by the time it's said and done. The opening tip controlled by Sholo, and it's into Alex Swanson's hands. Tipped out of bounds by the Falcons, and it'll be an inbound coming up for the Sholo Cougars. We're underway with Northland Basketball. It's presented by Choice Broadband. Thanks, everybody, for joining us for yet another season, our final day for high school basketball this season. And then we're on to the Indoor Football League and the Arizona Rattlers and Tucson Sugar Skulls as Sholo misses from outside. And Alex Swanson is there to scoop up the offensive rebound, put it in for Sholo, and they lead 2-0. Here is a drive on the baseline on the opposite end of the floor by the Lady Falcons. Jalen Nascio's first shot will not go in. And the rebound to Aubrey Wilson and Sholo. And Mackenzie Kulish for three from the corner. Count the basket and a foul. Mackenzie got contact, ended up on the ground. The shot went in from the corner. That's a big three-point basket. And Sholo has a great start in this one. That is a 5-0 start. And the first foul of the game whistled on the Lady Falcons. Meanwhile, Mackenzie Kulish calmly knocks home the shot. And our score is 6-0. 6-0 the lead for the Sholo Cougars. Janet Sanchez, yesterday's Sports Zone Radio Player of the Game in the Alchesay semifinal victory. Takes it from three-point land, dribbles in a couple of steps, and knocks down a mid-range jump shot for the first points for the Falcons. Meanwhile, Kulish for three. Again, missed that shot this time. And the offensive rebound belongs to, I believe that was Aubrey Wilson again, picking up the rebound for the Cougars. Championship basketball. The Sholo Lady Cougars have had a marvelous season as they go inside to Raquel Wilson, missed the shot. Offensive rebound for the Cougars. The lady inside was Sadie Hall, who got the rebound. And then she got fouled. It was Cameron Nacho, who has now picked up the first two fouls of the game for Alchesay. She'll leave for Coach Rick Sanchez. She checks out. Davelin Brown comes into the game. Championship basketball. So many times we've had the privilege at the Sports Zone of calling a championship basketball game or a championship football game or a baseball game. Too many right now to count, to be honest with you, because we have such great success from our White Mountains and Navajo Nations athletic teams that we cover here in Northland Basketball at the Sports Zone. A chance for a championship again. Three-point try is going to rim out, no good. Downtown from Jalen Nascio. And then in the paint, after an offensive rebound, Jaslyn Nosey will try to throw a pass to the baseline. That's going to tip out of bounds. Falcon fans thought for sure that was touched by Sholo, but the official says out of bounds off of the Falcons. So Sholo breaks the press, brings it across, and Aubrey Wilson will attack the paint. Nice little pass, but that's going to be off her sister Raquel's hands. She was on the baseline. Pass is going to tip off her hands out of bounds. It's a golden opportunity for Sholo to go up by six again. So the Falcons get it back. Jaslyn Ozy on the angle left side. She feeds it to Nascio on the baseline, and her dribble is knocked from her hands by Aubrey Wilson. Out of bounds. Possession Falcons for an inbound. 5 minutes, 44 seconds on the clock in the first quarter. It's Sholo 6, Alchesay 2 on the inbound. Nascio for a three-point try in the corner. That's no good. Rebounded by Raquel Wilson, and she'll dribble it off her hip. And that was just as she crossed into front court. So the basketball goes to the Alchesay Falcons. Janet Sanchez will try a three. Missed it. Rebound inside. Yeah, Jasmine Nosey got great position inside of Alex Swanson. And Nosey able to scoop it up and put it in. And it's a two-point lead for the Cougars. Sadie Hall fouled by Jasmine Nosey on her shot attempt near the free throw line. So that's going to be Jazz picking up her first foul of the game. And Sadie Hall gets an opportunity to add to a two-point Sholo lead here in the first quarter. And she'll do just that. One-handed push shot is up there and good for Sadie. Second try is going to bounce off the back iron. And Jasmine Nosey will have it up the floor. And she gets a pocket picked by Raquel Wilson. Strong defense by Raquel. Cougars have the basketball, playing against not just a great defending champion Alchesay Lady Falcon team, but playing against these Falcon fans as well. The Cougar fans just don't match the decibel level. Far fewer Cougar fans present here than Falcon fans. And here's a jump shot from the baseline. No good for the Cougars. There's going to be a whistle. And the official is going to call out the foul. I believe Alex Swanson is guilty of the foul. 4 minutes and 30 seconds left in the first quarter. 7-4, Sholo. Bounce pass inside. And that got away from the intended receiver, but there is Janet Sanchez for the Falcons to pick it up and put it in. And the Falcons are to within one right now. Alex Swanson, the drive. And she did not see Jaslyn Nosey collapsing down on defense in the middle of the paint, who stole her pass. So Jazz will bring it up into front court. Cheyenne Massey, and now back to Jaslyn again. Near the foul line, back outside. Massey for a three-point try, rebound Jazz. And her pass is slapped away and controlled by the Sholo Cougars. Aubrey Wilson got the steal. And Aubrey brings it down, left-hand shot good.
Aubrey Wilson.
Great job executing in transition. Great job running the floor by the Lady Cougars, and they're back in front by three. Tall pass for the Falcons to the right angle. That is flagged down by Cheyenne Massey. And then a beautiful pass by Jalen Nascio down to the baseline to Davlin Brown. That draws the second foul of the game now on Alex Swanson. And uh-oh, the floor general has to leave the floor. Alex was our Sports on Radio player of the game yesterday when Sholo won their semifinal game. They beat the Chin Lee Wildcats. Alex Swanson was terrific in that game. But now she has to go to the bench with her second foul. And Davlin Brown is the beneficiary. The first one is good. Second one's also good for Davlin. And it's a one-point game. Sholo still in front. Up the floor it goes. Grace Moore has it at the top of the key. Back to Raquel Wilson. Backdoor cut. Aubrey. Raquel finds with a beautiful pass. But then Grace Moore on the rebound of a missed Aubrey Wilson shot is going to slap it out of bounds. So back to the Falcons, and they can take their first lead of the game right here. 3:07 on the clock. First quarter to the right angle. Cheyenne Massey brings it out of the corner. Back to the top of the key. There's Jaslyn Nosey. She'll throw it right side to Corey Kosey, who's coming to the lineup. And now a pass deflected, stolen by Raquel Wilson. But she has trouble up the floor. She tried to pick up the dribble and pass it and fumbled it. It was taken right back by Janet Sanchez, who makes contact with Grace Moore. And that is going to be a personal foul on Grace.
Grace Moore, her first 13 foul. Timeout Sholo.
Timeout taken by Sholo here in the first quarter. They still have the lead, but what a game, what a start. And we'll grab this word in from our presenting sponsors of Northland Basketball. That's Choice Broadband. Stand by, everybody. Northland Basketball, presented by Choice Broadband.
With Choice Broadband, you can now get an even better internet plan for your home. Our fastest speeds are only $49.99 per month for the first 6 months. You can work, stream, surf, and play with the full power of our broadband network for our lowest price yet. Visit one of our Choice NTUA wireless locations nearest you to get started. Give us a call at 928-730-2273 or go online now to choice-wireless.com/broadband and order your home internet connection today. Choice NTUA Wireless. Navajo owned, Navajo proud.
Two shots.
The Alchesay Lady Falcons have just tied the 3A state championship game in the first quarter. 2:41 on the clock. Our score 9-9. Jasmine Nosey at the foul line. Or rather, no, that's Jen Sanchez at the foul line. She just made two free throws for Alchesay, and they have moved in front in this girls 3A state championship game. Well, for those of you listening on the radio back home, hopefully you're getting our signal now. But we had a problem. We weren't ready with our radio broadcast earlier. That led to domino effects of not getting that set on the local radio broadcast. But here we are now, everybody. I'm glad to have you as Jazz Nosey goes inside for a bucket for the Lady Falcons. And you hear the intensity of the crowd. Under 2 minutes now remaining in the first quarter of this 3A state championship game. And Sholo is not just facing the Alchesay Falcons, but this amazing crowd representing Alchesay. Aubrey Wilson tied up in the corner. Now Aubrey is going to get fouled. Nope, she got tied up. That'll be a jump ball. And the basketball is going to belong to Sholo for an inbound. With, as I said, now a minute and 40 remaining in the first quarter of this big matchup. Sholo, the number 6 seed in the state tournament, in what I believe is the first ever state championship game. And you know what? Cougars lost track of the time. I lost track of the time in a shot clock violation. They had no idea. And the quarter ends, or rather the possession ends. We got 85 seconds left in the quarter. And a hand check foul. Amberlyn Lindsay is going to get called for the Cougars. That's the third team foul, her first of the game. We got a minute and 22 seconds remaining in the quarter. And the inbound comes in for the Falcons. Alchesay trailed 6-0 to start the game before they finally scored. 6 points has been the largest lead that the Cougars have been able to develop, but now it's Alchesay in front, 12-9. Jan Sanchez from the top of the key. And her shot is no good. Rebound, Sadie Hall. Sholo will take over. 44 seconds left in the quarter. On the baseline, Sadie. And Sadie took too many steps.
Ramona Craig checks in for the Falcons. Raquel Wilson back in for the Cougars.
So after the too many steps, it'll be an inbound play for the Alchesay Falcons with 40.1 seconds left. Some subs come in as well to close out the quarter. And here we go. A pass tipped, taken away, stolen by Sholo. So the Cougars get the ball back. Here they go. No shot clock with 20 seconds left in the quarter. Downtown, Addison Cotterman has come in and quickly launches for Sholo. Missed the shot, but the long rebound is saved by Grace Moore. She went diving into the Alchesay bench. Sadie Hall inside, can't make it go. Tough defense by the Falcons. 2 seconds remaining, long shot on the way. Well, it was before the buzzer, but it did not go in for Jaslyn Nosey, and that's how the quarter comes to an end. In the 2023 Girls 3-8 State Championship game here at the Sports Zone, Northland Basketball is presented by Choice Broadband. We'll go to the second quarter. Alchesay in front by three in this big matchup in the Girls State Championship. Stand by.
I have to admit it. I am not an expert at everything. Now, if you want to talk to me about SEO and SEM and website optimization, I know it pretty darn well. But shopping for vehicles? That's a whole other world for me. That's why I go to Guy Hatch and his experts at Sholo Ford with my vehicle questions. They have been serving the White Mountains for a long time, long enough to have gained my trust. And when I come in and ask my questions, I don't get the normal runaround and what do we have to do to earn your business answers like some other guys. They simply answer my questions. They can help with navigating the ever-changing technologies with hybrids, EVs, and more. Help with the myriad of incentives to help me get the best deal possible and the best bank to get me the best rate and finance package. Don't take my word for it. See for yourself at Sholo Ford. They are on the east end of the Deuce, or visit sholoford.com.
Time for us to get back to the action, everybody. Welcome back in to our courtside location for the Arizona Interscholastic Association's Girls 3A State Championship game. And a long-distance shot on the way, a three-point try for Jaslyn Nosey. She misses that. Addison Cotterman gets the rebound for Sholo and gets immediately in trouble, struggling with to control the dribble. And lost it in front of the Alchesay bench. So the Falcons will get another chance as we get the second quarter underway with Northland Basketball here at the Sports Zone. It's brought to you by Choice Broadband and great sponsors like Mountain Mobile, Auto Glass, and Tint. They're going to bring you the halftime report coming up in a bit. Also, White Mountain Regional Medical Center, who present the Sports Zone Radio Player of the Game after each of our broadcasts. So we'll get to all of that. How about the overall record? This includes tournament play games as well, and that's what teams do report when people ask, if you're going to ask a team, what's your record? The AIA does not report the same record. Their overall record does not include tournament games. So let's count those. And Sholo comes into the game with a 24-9 record, 24-9 overall. They won the 3A East region. And you have to say Lady Falcons are 23-11, 23-11 the record for the Falcons. They did not win their region. They play in the 3A North region, right? Surprisingly, they have to drive through the entire 3A East region to get to the North and play their games, but that's what they want to play. And who can blame them for the desire to play up in the North, play on the Navajo Nation? The Alchesay Falcons just got a dose of some great Sholo defense, by the way, and a shot clock violation is assessed. Alchesay finished tied record-wise for third place with the Chinle Lady Wildcats in the 3A North during the regular season. Falcons had an 11-8 overall record according to games that the AIA counts. Those are non-tournament games. And they were 6-6 in the 3A North region. That tied them with Chinle, but they had the tiebreaker head-to-head with Chinle. And so, officially, they are the third-place team in the region for the season. Meanwhile, the defending champions get a rebound off a Sholo miss, and they'll bring it up into front court. Well, after the first quarter, and we have no scoring yet in the second period of this one, still 12-9, a minute and a half into the quarter. That didn't last long, though. I say it, and it was like summoning up Janet Sanchez, who knocks a three down for the Falcons. And now they're in front 15-9 over Sholo. Meanwhile, Ramona Gregg is going to commit a blocking foul. Sholo moving the ball up into front court. Well, let me give you some numbers from the first quarter. We have those for you. The Falcons, with a 12-9 lead at the end of the first quarter, shot 33% from the field. They were 4 out of 12 overall. They missed 7 three-point tries. Meanwhile, a takeaway, and Jen Sanchez takes it down and puts it in for the Falcons. They lead 17-9. What a run! And I think Aubrey Wilson just got away with a travel for Shola. Her teammate Raquel, sister, just missed a three-point try and another Falcons rebound. So Shola's gone cold. They led the game 8-2 at one point. That means a 15-1 scoring run by the Falcons. And I think we're going to get a Shola foul. We do. And then Sadie just picked up her first personal foul of the game. So 17-9 is our score, everybody. Mentioned that the Falcons shot 33.3% in the first quarter. Shola shot 25%. They were 3 out of 12. So again, both teams attempted 12 shots. Shola made one fewer, but they did make one three-point basket. They were 1 for 4. Falcons, I said, missed all 7 three-point tries in the first quarter. The Cougars, they're not shooting better than 25%. And by the way, that's not acceptable anyway. They know they got to shoot better than that. They are not shooting even as well as 25% here in the second quarter. I don't know the numbers yet. We'll get the stats at halftime from the AIA. But they have gone cold. And the first shot of the game for Andrea Suttle is a three-point make for the Falcons, who lead the game 20-9. Timeout Shola with 4:28 on the clock in the second quarter. Wow, amazing. A word from Ace Hardware of the White Mountains, everybody. Northland Basketball brought to you by Choice Broadband.
If this harsh winter makes it seem like the old groundhog saw his shadow and his cousin Fred's shadow and the shadow of some random groundhog in a van down by the river, then maybe it's time to head to Ace Hardware of the White Mountains for another bag of ice melt, some wood pellets, or maybe a trusty new snow shovel. Don't forget to pick up some birdseed while you're there, because the prices are so low that the birdseed is flying off the shelf at Ace Hardware in Sholo, Pine Top, and Heber Overgard. Ace Hardware wishes good luck to the Sholo Cougars and the Alchesay Falcons at the 3A State Tournament.
4 minutes and 28 seconds on the clock. The Mountain Mobile Auto Glass and Tint halftime report at the break. This place is rocking. I'm just letting you kind of enjoy it. And I hope you are enjoying. I hope you are having a good time. Sholo's got the basketball. Aubrey Wilson's in trouble again. She is just surrounded in the corner. And the defenders are able to once again force the turnover. The basketball belongs to the Alchesay Falcons. Ramona Gregg from the high post will send it outside. Jalen Nascio for a shot that won't go in. And this one rebounded by the Lady Cougars. Here they go. Alex Swanson. Going to flip it to the corner. And that's a three for Kulish. And Kulish knocks it down. Much needed help from Mackenzie Kulish. Her second three of the game. But Shola still trails by a bunch. It is 20-12, Alchesay. And after some hijinks in the backcourt, they're going to lose it. On a errant dribble by Wilson, taken away by Jaslyn Nosey, who brings it up the floor. Put it off the glass for the shot. It's good. Cholo trails again by 10. Alex Swanson. At the top to Aubrey Wilson on the angle left side, and the shot is good for Wilson.
3-point goal, Aubrey Wilson.
So a couple of big threes in the quarter. The difference is only 7 points. Cholo does need to play some of that defense that we saw them play yesterday against the Chinle Wildcats. They were tough. They've got to get a little more active, and they've got to do what they can to take the crowd out of it. The crowd is kind of having their way right now, aren't they? I mean, you can hear it back home. Quiet at the moment, but yeah, we're going to erupt again after Andrea Suttle goes inside, and Suttle off a feed from Gaz Nosey with the bucket under the basket in the paint. 24-15, and Mackenzie Kulish just threw the ball into the Cholo bench. That's a Cholo turnover. Well, one of the things that appears to be going on here is that it is so loud at times. It is so loud at times that that Cholo may not be hearing each other. They may not be able to communicate that well. Now, the Falcons, they're going to face some of that as well. They can't hear a lot when things are going on and the crowd erupts when they're on offense. But for Cholo in particular, they've got the basketball. This crowd is making it tough for them to communicate on the floor. Jalen Nascio takes a pass on the left angle for the Falcons. They've got the ball. Jaslyn Nosey has it knocked from her dribble by Mackenzie Kulish. Jaslyn hustles back, picks it up, and then delivers to Nascio on the angle left side. That'll bounce around and go in for the Falcons. That's the first basket of the game for Nascio. It'll be the third three of the quarter for the Falcons. Nascio's hit one. Jenna Sanchez has made one. Andrea Suttle with the three as well. Cholo to answer, and the shot is good. Alex Swanson got open on the left angle. And Swanson connects on a three. Well, the Cougars have made three threes in the quarter. The problem is, that's all they've made, while the Falcons, with their three threes, have complemented that with 3 2-point baskets as well. So they've outscored Cholo by the six I just reported, 15-9 in the second quarter. A miss from the top. That's Ramona Gregg with the miss. Rebound by Sadie Hall. Cholo's got the basketball. It's Mackenzie Kulish in the corner. Defender came out on her. Alex Swanson on the drive. Swanson missed the runner. Got her own rebound. And we'll get the ball here. 32 seconds in the quarter. Amberlynn Lindsay for three. That's going to bounce off no good. And Jazz Nosey is there for the Falcons for the rebound. 20 seconds left in the second quarter. The Mountain Mobile Auto Glass halftime report is on the way. And a pass to the baseline. That's out of bounds. That's going to be the Cougars basketball. Raquel Wilson comes into the game for the final 15 seconds of the first quarter. She replaces Mackenzie Kulish. We'll see if the Cougars can manage the ball against a full court press. And Raquel Wilson struggled with the handles. And she turns it over with 10 seconds on the clock in the first quarter. Falcons, cross-court pass. Jen Sanchez, shot good from three. And time expires in the first half. 30-18, but the way the Falcons played in the second quarter, it feels like it's so much bigger than that, doesn't it? They outscore Cholo 18-9. Doubled them up in that second quarter. To bring us to halftime, where in a moment we'll break it down on the Mountain Mobile Auto Glass halftime report. You know, they always have like a celebrate the 25th anniversary of state championship teams. I wonder here at halftime who were the girls 3A state champions 25 years ago. And oftentimes they'll do 50 years ago as well. We'll see what that looks like here in a little bit. We'll tell you all about it. Break it down on a radio broadcast. If you want to see the live video, you must. If you're going to watch the live video, you must go to the NFHS Network on our YouTube feed on the chat box there. You can find a link that we posted, and I would only trust the links posted by the Sports Zone. All those other links that are there, we have no idea what those are. We have no idea what they're all about, who they are. I would say don't trust them, but look for the Sports Zone, Sports Zone Radio, and our link to the NFHS Network. That will put you on our page on the network. If you will scroll down and click on any one of the old broadcasts that we've done right there, you'll see a bunch of videos on demand. Click on one of those. It will prompt you to subscribe to the NFHS Network. And then once you pay, you can search for this game really easy and watch the game. It's a simple 3 or 4 step process. But that's the only place to find the live video. And we would ask that you do it that way through the Sports Zone Radio page with that link on our YouTube channel. That way the Sports Zone can get credit for your subscription. It's halftime here. Alchesay 30. Sholo 18. We thank you for joining us, everybody, out on the court. The cheerleaders getting ready to dance for the Alchesay fans. And we'll break everything down for you on the Mountain Mobile Auto Glass halftime reports. The girls 3A state championship game. And the Falcons lead the Cougars 30-18. Stand by for the breakdown. Don't go anywhere.
Qualify for free internet with Choice Broadband. If you already have Choice Tribal Lifeline, then you may also qualify for a free internet connection with the Affordable Connectivity Program. Visit one of our Choice NTUA wireless locations nearest you to get started. Give us a call at 928-730-2273 or go online now to choice-wireless.com/ACP and get qualified for a free internet connection today. Choice NTUA Wireless. Navajo owned, Navajo proud.
Holbrook Family Dentistry is a proud partner of Sports Zone Radio's Northland Basketball. They've been serving Holbrook and the surrounding area since 2000, and they cheer for all our local teams and love it when the North succeeds. Holbrook Family Dentistry's 3 dentists are all general dentists from our local area, so they can perform most type of procedures in-house. They pride themselves on their ethics and kindness and genuinely love working with the communities of Northern Arizona. Come see us at Holbrook Family Dentistry on Iowa Street in Holbrook or call 928-524-6854.
Max your tax.
Max your tax refund with the car guys you know and can trust at Sholo Ford and Sholo. Take advantage of Guy Hatch's special volume pricing, Ford factory incentives, and max your tax refund to lower your payments. Max your tax and defer your payment. Max your tax as a down payment. Max your tax to max your trade allowance. Max your tax and get in that vehicle of your dreams. Sholo Ford will show you how. Whatever you're looking for, we probably have it in stock. Not only new Fords, but affordable cash cars to monster trucks, most makes and models. At Sholo Ford, we have the inventory and selection with shipments coming in every day to help the demand that comes at tax refund time. Because there's no better time to buy. Because you can max your tax. Max your tax refund. Lower your payment, defer it, or add it to your trade. And here at Sholo Ford, we'll help you with every step of the way. Check us out on the east end of the Deuce or at SholoFord.com.
Imagine this, a professional healthcare partner that's concerned about you, your choices, your health, your safety. At White Mountain Regional Medical Center in Springerville, choice and elevating your healthcare experience is the mission of our new CEO, experienced physicians, and friendly staff. Whether you need a rapid COVID-19 test, a vaccination, or you're looking to utilize the newest MRI, CT scan, or nuclear medicine technology, White Mountain Regional Medical Center, located in Springerville, is your healthcare partner when choices matter.
Happy New Year from Mountain Mobile Auto Glass and Tint. Just in time for our Valentine's special, we are introducing our new business partner, Cattleman's Steakhouse.
Yeehaw!
With every insured replacement, you can take your sweetheart out for the best prime rib on the mountain. Or choose salmon, sirloin steak, cod, pork chops, chicken, or a variety of other delicious dinners.
You are the best, honey.
And with the Valentine's special, you also get 2 movie tickets to the WME theaters. And this year, you could take your Valentine's Valentine to a VIP experience to see the King of Country, George Strait, live in concert. That's right, we're giving away two premium VIP tickets to see George Strait, Chris Stapleton, and Little Big Town live in Phoenix, including VIP parking.
Yes!
Don't miss out on our Best Valentine special.
536-597. Welcome to the Mountain Mobile Halftime. A complete first half breakdown of tonight's Sports Zone Radio Game of the Week broadcast. This is the Mountain Mobile Halftime.
Celebrating their 25th championship.
It's halftime, everybody.
Let's give a warm welcome to the 1998 3A conference champion, Winslow Bulldogs.
I'm just checking to see what the public address announcer, Jim Barnett, would announce as the team that is being honored from 25 years ago.
Basketball program in our state has made as many state championship appearances as Winslow. The team in front of you won Winslow's fourth title after beating St. John's 74-33 in the 1998 final. That year, the Bulldogs won a school record 31 games. In charge of the team was one of the state's coaching legends, Don Petronovich, a National Federation of State High School Associations Hall of Famer. Let's welcome here today from the 1998 squad, Nadia Begay. Miranda Gilbert. Mindy Hernandez. Kimberly Jackson. Verlaine Cascoli. Dr. Crystal Lee. Francine McCurtain.
So they introduced seven members of the 1998 Winslow Lady Bulldog State Championship team, including the current head coach of the Chinle Wildcats, Francine McCurtain, was just now introduced. And a big congratulations to Coach McCurtain and all those ladies from that Winslow Championship team from 25 years ago. Got some numbers for you from the first half. Sholo actually improved on their shooting in the second quarter over the first. They shot an even 25% in the first period. They actually improved to 28.6% in the second quarter, but that's missing 15 out of 21 shot attempts. Yeah, so that isn't going to get it done if you're playing a team that is doing as well as the Falcons have been doing. Remember, the Falcons shot 33.3% in the first quarter. They ended up shooting 58.3% in the second quarter. And let me correct on Sholo. That was actually, they actually improved to 33.3% in the second quarter. Overall for the half, shooting 28.6%. Also, the Alchesay Lady Falcons are shooting 45.8%. percent overall for the game, so 45.8 versus 28.6%. Also, they're about to honor L.A. Williams from longtime KTNN announcer. Let's check in on that.
Across countless sports, on February 1st, 2023, North American Indigenous Athletics inducted longtime Dene broadcaster, sports announcer, commentator, public speaker, and a Holbrook High School class of 1985 alum, L.A. Williams, into the Hall of Fame in the category of media. L.A. has worked as a sports radio broadcaster for nearly 30 years, bringing sporting events, commentating, and announcing in the Navajo language through the radio airwaves at KTNN, where she was dubbed the voice of Navajo sports. L.A. is now the program manager at Dene College's KXWR station, where she trains students to become the next generation of Navajo radio broadcasters in hopes of continuing the Dene language. Here to support L.A. on her outstanding achievement is Sean Martinez with the Phoenix Suns and Phoenix Mercury, and live presenter for senior director, a graduate of Window Rock High School in 1985 and graduate of Fort Lewis College, and he's also known as DJ Tribal Touch. Welcome, Sean, and congratulations, LA.
So LA Williams has been honored here at halftime. She has been recently inducted into a National Hall of Fame, a National Indigenous Sports organization. I don't know the organization exactly, but she was recently inducted as a Hall of Fame broadcaster. And congratulations to LA Williams for that great honor. And do me a favor real quick. Sorry about that. I'm about to lose the charge on a battery, so I had to have some assistance on that. But again, congratulations to LA Williams. And that's an honor, well-deserved, very popular broadcaster for so many years on the Navajo Nation and all the work and experience that she has. Here at halftime of this girls' matchup, the Alchesay Falcons lead Sholo 30-18. 30-18 is our score here at halftime. Let me give you the numbers for the Falcons. They are led by Jenneth Sanchez. Jen definitely gets a lot of headlines, her and Jazz Lenozzi leading that team. But it is Jazz that gets probably more of the recognition out there. And in the last two games, Jen Sanchez is proving that, you know, this is not a one-dimensional team at all. And Jen leading with 14 first-half points. Jaslyn has 6 points. Andrea Settle with 5 points. Jalen Nascio has 3 points. And Davlin Brown has 2 points in the first half. The Sholo Cougars are led by Mackenzie Kulish. She had a pair of three-point baskets and a free throw. She's got 7 first-half points. Alex Swanson with 5 points, Aubrey Wilson with 5 points, and Sadie Hall has one single point in the game. And that's going to bring us to a 30-18 score. Check some other quick numbers for you. Total turnovers. Sholo's turned the ball over 14 times. Alchesay has turned the ball over 11 times. Rebound numbers, the Falcons have out-rebounded Sholo 16-13 total. Offensive rebounds are even at 5 apiece. And Alchesay with a slight edge, 11-8 as far as defensive rebounds go. Really, that's not a big enough disparity for the difference on the scoreboard. So you can't really pin it on that. And Sholo has only turned the ball over 3 more times. I guess the combination of the two starts to add up. But it is that failure to shoot the ball well, that's been Sholo's undoing. Again, almost a 20% advantage in shooting by the Falcons for the first half over Sholo. Alchesay shooting about where you want to be, about 45-8%. You'll take that any day of the week, especially in a championship game where you know you're playing a tough defense. Sholo shooting at 28.6% in the first half. Have got to get that number improved. And maybe turn the tables as far as defense goes. By the way, Sholo has stolen the ball 8 times. Falcons have 5 steals, so Sholo does have the advantage there in that defensive category. Well, we're going to take one final break and a word in from Mountain Mobile Auto Glass and Tint. Everybody, they bring you the halftime report on the Northland basketball broadcast of this 3A state championship game. It's presented by Choice Broadband. We're back with the second half right after this.
Happy New Year from Mountain Mobile Auto Glass and Tint. Just in time for our Valentine's special, we are introducing our new business partner, Cattleman's Steakhouse.
Yeehaw!
With every insured replacement, you can take your sweetheart out for the best prime rib on the mountain. Or choose salmon, sirloin steak, cod, pork chops, chicken, or a variety of other delicious dinners.
You are the best, honey.
And with the Valentine's special, you also get 2 movie tickets to the WME theaters. And this year, you could take your Valentine to a VIP experience to see the King of Country, George Strait, live in concert. That's right, we're giving away 2 premium VIP tickets to see George Strait, Chris Stapleton, and Little Big Town live in Phoenix, including VIP parking.
Yes!
Don't miss out on our best Valentine's special.
5, 3, 6, 5, 9. 7, 2,
Back to the action. The second half gets underway, everybody. Welcome back into the 2023 Arizona Interscholastic Association 3A state championship game. And a ball tipped into backcourt by the Sholo defense. Nope, that was Alchesay that got the tip. The ball goes out of bounds. Here comes a reset. 7:42 on the clock. The second half is underway. Northland basketball is presented by Choice Broadband and some great sponsoring partners like Ace Hardware of the White Mountains. We thank them for the partnership. And Beeman Well Drilling. Beeman Well Drilling helping us bring you this coverage of the 3A state championship game between the number 6 seeded Sholo Cougars and the number 8 seed, the Alchesay Lady Falcons. Here's the inbound, and Falcons bring it into front court. Jalen Nascio with the basketball. Her pass to the corner, and then a follow-up pass is stolen by Sholo. Alex Swanson drives, and her pass is intercepted. Jenith Sanchez has the ball. Sanchez drives. Dish now outside. Jalen Nascio. And her shot is no good. That's going to tip out of bounds. Back to the Sholo Cougars. So Sholo's had a couple of nice stops on defense. We'll see what they can do with the basketball here. 12-point advantage for the Lady Falcons. Sadie Hall to the high post. Alex Swanson and now Raquel Wilson inside to Aubrey. Aubrey will turn and force a shot up there. That's no good. Tried to fight for the rebound. Got her hands on it, but then threw it out of bounds. Thought her teammate was right behind her. Threw it kind of over her head, and the ball goes out of bounds. And our score stays. Alchesay 30. Sholo 18. Inbound and into front court. Nice hesitation. And a shot good for Jaslyn Nosey. So Jaslyn opens up the second half scoring and extends the lead for the Falcons to 14 points. Alchesay is the defending 3A state champions, and they won the 2A state champion back in 2019. They've got the experience. Raquel Wilson missed a three-point try. Rebound. Sholo, they'll keep it alive. Turnaround at the free throw line by Aubrey Wilson is blocked. Cameron Nachi with the big play, and she's going to go coast to coast, but her shot is going to roll off. No good. Rebound, Sholo. They're going to race it up the floor. Aubrey Wilson trying to attack. And she double dribbles. Lost the ball. So turnovers getting to the Cougars here early in the second half. And I feel like the energy in the place, the intensity is a big part of that. Can you imagine the stress level of a 17 or 18-year-old young lady as you play against this? Nice pass by Jaslyn Ozzie. Give her the assist to Cameron Nachu. And Nachu gets her first points in the game. The Falcons have scored the first two buckets of the second half. Raquel Wilson trying to throw a pass to Aubrey Wilson near the corner. Will handcuff her a bit. Aubrey couldn't handle it. That'll force a Sholo. Timeout, everybody. Thanks for joining us for this broadcast of Northland Basketball, presented by Choice Broadband.
The team at Beeman Well Drilling is like a great football team. They work hard, they work as a team, and they play to win. Their reputation is second to none, and they proudly call the White Mountains their home, even though they complete projects throughout the entire southwestern United States and beyond. No project is too big or too small for Beeman Well Drilling, so when the time comes for you to punch a hole in the ground, remember the White Mountains' top well drilling team, Beeman Well Drilling. Call anytime, 928-205-7647. Go deep with Beeman Well Drilling.
Thank you to Beeman Well Drilling. Thank you to all of our great sponsoring partners of Northland Basketball and so much of what we do at the Sports Zone. Those sponsoring partners include Holbrook Family Dentistry. Holbrook Family Dentistry joined us this season as a partner with the Sports Zone, and we can't say thank you enough to the good people at Holbrook Family Dentistry. And since we are in the big sombrero, the Madhouse on McDowell, the Veterans Memorial Coliseum, the crowd here, it's almost like it's in the DNA of the fabric of the building. You've got to do the wave. And so The crowd is starting the wave. They're getting into it. This is a place that untold number of times back in the Phoenix Suns days, right? That you got the wave moving through here. Shola with a steal. Long pass from Alex Swanson to Sadie Hall. Drop it back to Mackenzie Coolidge for a three-point try. It's no good. Aubrey Wilson's rebound and unable to make the follow. And this rebound now down to the Alchesay Lady Falcons. Up the floor it goes. Jen Sanchez. Now to Jalen Nascio on the angle left side. And she'll give it to Jaslyn Nosey. 4.5 minutes on the clock. Jaslyn dribbles toward the paint area, and it is going to be knocked away, knocked from her possession. Cholo gets the steal. Alex Swanson brings it across. Here's that Alchesay crowd asking for defense. And the shot missed from the corner. Aubrey Wilson couldn't make it. Up into front court. Jaslyn picks up the dribble. Now to Jen Sanchez, and she is going to go around the defender, Mackenzie Coolidge, for a shot at the basket. Mackenzie, trying to block the shot, is going to pick up the personal foul for Mackenzie. That I have that as her first foul of the game.
And also number 13, Mackenzie Coolidge, her first team foul. Sanchez on the line shooting.
Two shots on the way for Jen Sanchez. And able to make the first one. And she has 15 points now in the game to lead the Lady Falcons. 35-18 is the score. Alchesay in front. Second try is going to be off the mark. Rebound Cholo. And here comes the Cougars into front court. Raquel Wilson tried to drive and dish, and that did not fool Jaslyn Nosey at all. She steals it, takes it right away, and Raquel Wilson almost steals it back. She was determined after having it taken from her possession. She tried to get it back on the steal. She was intentional about that whole thing. You could see the mounting frustration and the desire to get it back. Did a good job picking her pocket, but couldn't control it. Went out of bounds. Now, Sanchez for a three-point try. That's going to miss, and it's going to tip around, and that's controlled by Alchesay. They've got the basketball. Jaslyn Nosey at the left elbow. Back outside to Cheyenne Massey for the runner. That's no good there. Follow try is also no good, and Cheyenne Massey gets the offensive rebound. Swing it around. Wide open three. Jalen Nascio. That's a three, everybody. 38-18. So after Cholo led 8-2, how about a 36-10 run by the Falcons? Sadie Hall answers with a baseline jump shot that goes in for Cholo, but the momentum, the crowd, the energy, it all belongs right now to the Lady Falcons. And it was a foul away from the ball. That's going to be a moving screen, I think. Cheyenne Massey picks
Player
up the foul.
Foul. Number three, Cheyenne Massey. First team foul.
First whistle Corey in the Kosei second half on the Falcons. Corey Kosei comes into the game, replacing Jalen Nascio for the Falcons. 2 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the third period. Here's the inbound. And up the floor. To Grace Moore, underneath, Sadie Hall. Sadie has a knock from her hands, ripped out of there. Active defense by the Falcons. They have turned things up a notch or two. Davelin Brown, jump shot from the left side. The 16-footer is good for Davelin. Everybody getting involved for Alchesay. 40-20, they lead. 2 minutes remaining in the quarter. And Alex Swanson has it knocked from her dribble out of bounds by Jaslyn Nosey. And Jaslyn got dinged up a bit on her right lower leg area, but I think she's just fine. Looking for the inbound. Amberlyn Lindsay comes into the game and throws the ball in to Raquel Wilson. Raquel dribbling. Mackenzie Kulish, Amberlyn Lindsay for three now. Playing catch a bit, and finally Amberlyn got a look at it. Tried the three, and that did not go in. Lindsay looking for her first shot from the field. Falcons with the ball, and a minute and 28 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Jaslyn Nosey dribbling out on top. Has to pick up the dribble, look for help. Well, gets knocked around. She finds Davlin Brown wide open on the baseline. Sholo trying to get out there and provide some help defense. And Brockett, her left Davlin wide open underneath. So that shot is good, and it's 42-20. Meanwhile, Cheyenne Massey has committed her second foul of the game.
Second team foul.
So Coach Sanchez invites Cheyenne to have a seat for a moment with those now two personal fouls. And Amberlyn Lindsay throws it in to Raquel Wilson for Shola. To the high post, Grace Moore now back on the angle right side. And off the glass, the long three is good for Alex Swanson. I'm sure she called it. I'm sure you would have heard it if the crowd wasn't so loud. Give her the bank shot, everybody. 40 seconds remaining in the third period. Falcons with the basketball. Jazz knows it behind the back dribble. And then she has it stolen. Great job by Raquel Wilson. Good steal. Amberlyn Lindsay too strong. Sadie Hall rebound block shot there. 20 seconds remaining in the third period. No shot clock. Runner missed by Alex Swanson. Rebound Sadie Hall. She got fouled. Two shots on the way for Sadie and the Cougars with 11.8 seconds remaining in the quarter. That is Jen Sanchez that committed the foul. One foul in the game now on Jenna. And now two shots for Sadie. Second one is good for Sadie Hall. 10 seconds now remaining in the quarter. Here it goes. Into front court. 3 seconds on the clock. Jazz Nosey. She gets by one defender. Dishes. Shot is up and good. Count it. And I believe that's a good call. I mean, it was very, very close, but you can see the backboard that lights up when the with time expires, and I believe the release was good. I didn't actually see, it was such a good pass delivered by Jazz. I didn't see who made the shot. I'll find out here for you as we go into the fourth quarter and a 20-point Alchesay lead trying to win a back-to-back 3A state championship. Doing this time over the Sholo Cougars, 44-24, big lead for Alchesay. The fourth quarter is next. Northland basketball in the 3A state championship presented by Choice Broadband. Stand by.
With Choice Broadband, you can now get an even better internet plan for your home. Our fastest speeds are only $49.99 per month for the first 6 months. You can work, stream, surf, and play with the full power of our broadband network for our lowest price yet. Visit one of our Choice NTUA wireless locations nearest you to get started. Give us a call at 928-730-2273 or go online now to choice-wireless.com/broadband and order your home internet connection today. Choice NTUA Wireless. Navajo owned, Navajo proud.
The team at Beam and Well Drilling is like a great football team. They work hard, they work as a team, and they play to win. Their reputation is second to none, and they proudly call the White Mountains their home, even though they complete projects throughout the entire southwestern United States and beyond. No project is too big or too small for Beam and Well Drilling, so when the time comes for you to punch a hole in the ground, remember the White Mountains' top well drilling team, Beam and Well Drilling. Call anytime, 928-205-7647. Go deep with Beam and Well Drilling.
Time now to begin the final 8 minutes of regulation, the fourth quarter. We'll get underway, and the Falcons are going to get the first inbound to start this. Janet Sanchez to throw it in for the Falcons. They will start the fourth quarter with a 20-point advantage over Sholo, 20-point lead, 44-24, and they will start it with Janet Sanchez. Jaslyn Nosey is out there on the floor. Also in this lineup for the Falcons, we've got Andrea Suttle, Corey Kosay, and Davelin Brown start the Falcon fourth quarter. Here comes a shot from the outside, and Falcons going to miss that. It's going to tip out and belong to Sholo. So the fourth quarter begins like that. The Cougars got to make a move in a hurry if they want to win their 25th game of the year. But more importantly, if they want to win a state championship. The two are mutually the same. If you win one, you win the other one. And Amberlyn Lindsay spots up on the right side with a mid-range Sholo jump shot. That is good. Cougars get it down to an 18-point difference. So the first goal, as usual in a situation like this, right, is can you get the score down to single digits? It's the first effort you make, right? And then you try to whittle away at that lead that the opponent has, and that's what Sholo's got to concern themselves with. The crowd here, the Falcon crowd's taking a bit of a breather. They have been at a fever pitch almost the entire way, so they need a rest, and they're taking a much-deserved rest with their team in front by 18, because once we start getting into the final moments, they're going to amp it back up again for the celebration, aren't they? If their team holds on and they get this victory. Travel by the Falcons. We'll see if Alchesay goes in as a team, if they go into the same kind of lull as the fans have kind of gone into. Cougars bring it across. They've got the basketball here with 6:48 remaining in regulation. They throw it to the baseline. To Aubrey Wilson. Wilson delivers inside to Raquel, who wanted a foul and did not get it. And it is going to be Alchesay's basketball. Coach wants a full court press. He's going to get his defense. She is going to get her defense all set up. That's Coach Christy Francis. I want to remind you, everybody, you're listening to Mix 98 KRFM Sholo, the broadcast home of Sports Zone Radio. And we get a whistle on Corey Kosay of Alchesay, and then the Falcons will call a timeout. We have the third quarter stats for you here. Shooting percentage, the Falcons just continue to get it done. They shot 50% in the third period. Sholo shot 15.4%, 2 of 13 from the field. Overall in the game, the Falcons have shot twice as good. They have a 42.2% shooting percentage in the entire game for three quarters. Sholo sitting at 23.5%. Now let's take a look at the turnover number, because that's a big number. Sholo's number starting to mount. Sholo's turned the ball over 21 times to 16 for the Falcons. Sholo has still stolen the ball more. They've stolen it 12 times to Alchesay's 9. And the Falcons will inbound the basketball. Hey, I want to take this opportunity as well to say, I know she's undoubtedly not listening right now, but from her hospital bed, I want to wish a speedy recovery and say God bless you to Linda Philbrook, who is our business manager and sales manager at White Mountain Radio, at the Petricom radio stations. I do a couple of things, not just the Sports Zone, but I run a group of stations, radio stations called White Mountain Radio. There's Jaslyn Nosey, and then Jazz with a steal. Jazz went inside and got the layup, and then the Falcons stole it, and then Jazz got fouled. Why, Sholo, let me get the number here real quick. Looks like Amberlyn Lindsay. He's got two fouls in the game on Amberlyn. We've got 6:02 remaining in regulation, 20-point Falcon lead, 46-26 our score. But Linda Philbrook, she took a spill on the ice last night and hurt herself, and it turns out she broke her hip and will require hip replacement surgery tomorrow morning. And that is just a very tough circumstance to deal with so hard. And Our thoughts and prayers are with our very good friend and our colleague at White Mountain Radio. That's Linda Philbrook. And she deals with that medical emergency. And if you would just maybe lift Linda's name up in your prayers that everything will go well, that the surgery is successful, and that she will have a strong and fast recovery from that injury. Meanwhile, in the basketball game in front of us, a foul is whistled on the Lady Falcons. That sends Aubrey Wilson to the line for a couple of foul shots. Into the game comes Abby Jim. Abby in for the first time. Aubrey Wilson with two foul shots made. And it's 46-28. Alchesay in front. Cougars have to make a move right now. 5.5 minutes left in regulation. The Alchesay Falcons working on winning their third out of their last three state championship game appearances. And the streak may actually be more than that. I'm just saying that's what I just real quick, without jumping into the archives, I know for sure they won the 2A championship in 2019. He won last year's 3A state championship. And now there is this. Janet Sanchez, by the way, just picked up her second foul of the game to send Alex Swanson to the foul line for two shots. Swanson misses the first one. Cholo's come out and outscored Alchesay in the early going of the fourth quarter, but you may have to outscore them for a while for it to really start to make a big impact. 17-point difference right now. Aubrey Wilson slaps Janet Sanchez's pass. Almost got the steal, but Janet's able to regain control. Great, great ball handling by Jasnozy. She was able to take on three defenders before dishing for a score. Grace Moore just now committed the foul on Tori Kose. Hammered her pretty hard, was trying to prevent the basket, but the release happened a little bit before Grace could get there, and so the shot is good. And after hitting the deck pretty hard, Tori Kose gets a chance for a three-point play. She'll miss it. They got the rebound, but then Aubrey Wilson stole that, and Aubrey makes the shot in transition for Sholo. 48-31. Cougar lead right now. And another steal by Aubrey Wilson. She just lurked and came in from behind and got the steal. Her jump shot is no good, though. And Aubrey is going to knock another possession out of the hands of the Falcons. And a travel called on Alex Swanson. Falcons 4:28 remaining in regulation. Here comes the inbound. And Mackenzie Coolish fouls Jaslyn Ozy. Two fouls in the game on Mackenzie. Team foul number four on Sholo. 17-point difference. This is going to be an inbound on the sideline. First, they want to get Sadie Hall into the lineup. Sadie replaces Grace Moore for Sholo. Sadie joins Mackenzie Coolidge, Raquel Wilson, Alex Swanson, and Aubrey Wilson. Inbound. Falcons have brought in Katuras Spangler. Sprangler, and you get a steal. Alex Swanson takes it up, puts it in. It's 15 points right now with 4 minutes and 3 seconds remaining in the fourth period. 48-33, the Falcons in front of Sholo. Janet Sanchez on her pass is hacked for a foul by Raquel Wilson. That's Raquel's first foul today. 16 foul. 3:54 now remaining in regulation. Here comes the inbound. Jan Sanchez gets it into Tori Kose. Drop it back to Jaslyn Ozy. And she draws a crowd of defenders. Long pass underneath, and the shot is no good for Abby Jim. Alex Swanson driving and going between the defenders, and she comes down hard. She twisted her ankle, I think. She is on the ground in a lot of trouble. Ton of pain. She is in backcourt and can't make it up this way. Stands up, takes a couple of steps. Well, we get a foul called on Raquel Wilson. That's now her third foul of the game.
Official timeout on the floor.
And Alex Swanson is back down on the deck. So they're going to take an official timeout and look over Alex Swanson. We hope she is okay. Well, Alchesay outscored Sholo 12-9 in the first quarter. They outscored them 18-9 in the second quarter. Kept the trend going in the third period. Alchesay outscored Sholo 16-6. Sholo has reversed those tables in the fourth quarter, outscoring the Falcons 9-2. But still trailing by 15 with limited time remaining. 3 minutes and 25 seconds left in the girls' 3A state championship game. Our broadcast of Northland Basketball is presented by Choice Broadband and some outstanding sponsoring partners of ours, like White Mountain Regional Medical Center, like Ace Hardware of the White Mountains. Thank you to Ace Hardware, Sholo, Pinetop, and Lakeside locations. Holbrook Family Dentistry, a great sponsoring partner of ours here at the Sports Zone. Jazz Nosey at the line, and Jazz was unable to make that foul shot on a 1-1. Aubrey Wilson jump shot from the left baseline. That's no good either for Sholo. Down to 3:10 remaining in the basketball game. Looking more and more like the Alchesay Falcons are going to celebrate another championship. Jan Sanchez drives left side. Shot good after contact. Count the basket. Foul on Amberlynn Lindsay. And more of this crowd getting involved for the Alchesay Falcons. Checking out of the game now for Sholo is
Addison Cotterman checks in for Sholo.
Raquel Wilson. She is replaced by Addison Cotterman, and Jan Sanchez will go to the foul line and try to make this a three-point play. She does. Got a nice bounce. The ball went in, and Jan's got 18 points in the game. Teammate Jazz Linozzi, 10 points. 2:47 remaining. 51-33, Alchesay in front. Addison Cotterman. Left side on the angle for a Mackenzie Kulish jump shot. That didn't go in. Rebound. Amberlynn Lindsay, and she just kept battling with it. Able to make the shot for Sholo. The lead is 16 points right now for the Falcons. Sanchez. Guarded by Lindsay. Drops it off to Corey Kosay. Falcons will run a little weave out and on the top and give a jump shot to Abby Jim. The shot is no good. Sholo rebound. Mackenzie Kulish to Addison Cotterman for a three on the right side. And that one's no good. Tipped around. Knocked out of bounds. Sholo got a hand on it last. Out of bounds to the Falcons with a minute 53 remaining in regulation. Well, basketball fans, are you ready for this place to go nuts? Because unless Sholo now pulls a miracle off in the final minute and 50, it's going to be a Falcons championship here for 20. Well, it's 2022 season, right? Officially. Jazz drives, dishes. Abby Jim's shot rejected. I think that was Addison Cotterman who rejected the shot, and then Cotterman bumps Nosey and narrowly, I think, avoided an intentional foul call. Very aggressive push on the sideline right in front of the Alchesay bench. And Addison will exit the game. That was probably a sign of some frustration there with the foul committed. And on the one-and-one, Jazz knows he misses the shot. Amberlynn Lindsay for a three-point try. Sholo misses that one. A minute 15 left. Well, the Cougars still playing. Cougars still working hard out there. And now Sholo is going to start to bring some bench in. Coming in is Tatum Moore checking in. Also, the two Boyce sisters. Jordan Boyce is in. Jaylee Boyce is in. Sholo is conceding. Alchesay has brought their entire bench in as well, basically, to get a little playing time in a state championship game. Good move by Coach Rick Sanchez for the Falcons, who are going to win this game. Good move and a classy move by the head coach of Sholo, Christy Francis. And I got the basketball. The basketball came rolling out under the table right into my hands. Had it for a moment, and I just gave a really great assist to the official. Big cheer goes up for Jenith Sanchez, who just came out of the game. 50 seconds away from an Alchesay State Championship. Boyce has it, and she throws it right into the hands of one of those Lady Falcons. Here they go up the floor, and a foul is committed. That might be Amberlynn Lindsay that committed the foul. I'm not sure she was actually trying to commit that foul. It wasn't Amberlynn, actually. They say it was Jaylee Boyce. I didn't think that Amberlynn was really being very aggressive there. She just ended up toppling on top of the player, and this is Camia Sanchez. And she makes a foul shot, gets to get into the scoring column in a state championship game. You gotta love that. 17 points separate these two teams. Alchesay 52, Sholo 35. Falcons about to win a championship. That ball's gonna tip around and go out of bounds. The Falcons are gonna go to a 24-11 overall record in winning the state championship. Inbound for the Falcons. And Sholo ties it up with 25.4 seconds remaining. Well, I guess we could go about announcing the Sports Zone Radio's player of the game, presented by White Mountain Regional Medical Center. 20 seconds left in this one. Amberlynn Lindsay's jump shot is going to be short for Sholo. Rebound Falcons. 15 seconds. Ball is stolen by Boyce. 6 seconds left. Playing to the end. And a jump shot that's no good. Here's the final buzzer. Here's the celebration. Lady Falcons have won their second straight 3A state championship in Arizona, and they did it convincingly over the Sholo Cougars, 52-35, making that long trip from the mountains for these thousands of Falcon fans well worth the drive. They love it, and you can bet the celebration is going to be on. And when they celebrate in White River, it's a big celebration. It goes on for a while. These girls are going to be treated like the superstars they are in the days that follow, as they are honored by the people of the White Mountain Apache tribe. And since 2019, The Alchesay Lady Falcons have three state championships, a two-way title in 19, and now two back-to-back 3A state championships. Their head coach, Rick Sanchez, is a masterful guide to this team. He knows how to motivate for absolute certain. Let's announce the Sports Zone Radio's player of the game, and this one is presented by White Mountain Regional Medical Center. For a second game in a row, it's Jenneth Sanchez. Jen Sanchez has... She took over the team in the playoffs. Her teammate, Jaslyn Ozy, gets a lot of the credit, for some considered perhaps the most talented player in all of our region of Arizona. But the real leadership has been displayed by Jen Sanchez, and 18 points in the game for Jen, a couple of threes. And for a second game in a row, she is the Sports Zone Radio's player of the game. So big congratulations to Jen. She is a senior, playing her final game ever, and doing it in the way that you always hope you get to. The desire is always go out on top, go out as a state champion. For Jen Sanchez and the rest of the seniors on this team, they get to do just that. The seniors include Jalen Nascio, Cheyenne Massey, Andrea Suttle. Corey Kose is a senior as well. Kamaya Sanchez, a senior. Davalyn Brown, a senior. What a great group. If we can, we probably want to have a quick word, not just with Jen Sanchez, but also with maybe Davalyn, who's been such a big producer, Corey Kose, Cheyenne Massey. We'll see if we get an opportunity to speak to any of them. Sholo Cougars getting acknowledgement from their fans and from the Alchesay fans as well, as they get the runners-up trophy. They're going to take a picture real quick before the gold basketball is awarded to Alchesay. Wait till you hear that, everybody. This place is about to erupt when the hardware is distributed. They'll give one more round of applause for the Sholo Cougars after a photo opportunity.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the state championship trophy is AIA Executive Board President Jim Dean. Back to back to head coach Rick Sanchez and the Alchesay Falcons.
The Alchesay Lady Falcons are being presented the gold basketball. 3A state champions for another time for the Lady Falcons. It's amazing. That is unbelievable. That is unbelievable. It's a complete team victory for the Falcons, but that team includes these great fans. I gotta tell you, they make it so hard on their opponents. It is so difficult to keep your composure, so difficult to maintain your confidence level. And every mistake you make when you're playing a big playoff game against the Falcons is amplified by the effect of this group of fans. So give these fans a lot of credit, because you know you're going to contend with that when you're the opponent. And just knowing that makes its way into your psyche before you ever play the first moment of basketball against them. And in the playoffs, it is tough. It is tough to beat the Alchesay Lady Falcons. They were led to victory by the Sports Zone Radio's player of the game. Tonight, Jenneth Sanchez. Well, we're just sticking around right now, sticking around for a bit. They are doing photos and and more, and somewhere along the line, they're going to get to cut down the nets as well. Somewhere along the line, we're going to try to get a discussion with our player of the game. I want to remind everybody that we will have the boys championship game at 6 p.m. Start a whole new online broadcast for that. And we do this because we know that some people, it might be the only way that they're going to be able to catch the broadcast is to listen to the online radio feed on our YouTube and Facebook channels. Clearly you're not able to see the live video. You've got to subscribe to the NFHS to do that, and I would encourage you to do that. I would highly encourage you to subscribe there versus listening to our YouTube radio feed, because really you want to see the video, right? You really do want to see the video, and so that would be my recommendation. Subscribe to the NFHS. There is a link on our YouTube chat box. If you go in there, scroll around, look for Sports Zone Radio. We posted a link to our NFHS page, and if you will scroll down on that page and click on one of the games that we've already broadcast, it will then ask you to subscribe. Once you do that, it'll bring that game up. But in the search box, then you search for the player of the game. All right, sorry about that. You search for Sports Zone Radio. And once you do that, you'll find us. You can search for your game, Monument Valley coming up, and then you can watch the live video. What a place, what an environment. There's a lot of people that don't like the idea of the championship games here at Veterans Memorial Coliseum. Well, I just have to say, there might be newer facilities out there for sure, but this place serves well the purpose that is intended. I don't think that I would complain a whole lot. I do not think I would complain a whole lot about it. We're going to talk to Jenith Sanchez in just a moment. We'll talk to Janet Sanchez here in just a moment, and we'll see if we can talk to one or two of the other seniors. As well, the media, they are being hounded by the media, as you would expect. They're cutting down the nets, everybody. One by one, these Lady Falcons getting making their way up the ladder. Getting a chance to cut one of those strings. And finally, a chance to speak with the lady of the moment. A chance to talk to a bona fide superstar. And the Sports Zone Radio's player of the game after an Alchesay championship win over the Shoulder Cougars in the girls 3A state championship. Let's talk to the player of the game. It's presented by White Mountain Regional Medical Center. This is Janet Sanchez. Janet, congratulations.
Thank you.
Wow. All this hard work and the payoff. Unbelievable today. Congratulations on
the
win.
Thank you.
What was that like out there for you?
It felt amazing. It felt relieving, and I'm just super proud of my team.
You took over this team, Jen. I mean, I don't know what the team says or how it's like for you, but from an outsider looking at the team, watching you play, to me, this was your team. You took it over this year. Coming down the stretch, it's like you were on a mission. Is that fair to say?
Yeah. This is what we were dreaming of the beginning of the season. This is what we worked for ever since the beginning of the season.
This team was so good. And, you know, after you lost such great players from last year's team that won a championship, I looked at your team and I knew there was talent, but saw you play a little bit. You went 6-6 in the 3A North region and your games played up there. You finished in third place. And I thought, I know you've got it, what it takes to win, but I wasn't sure it was all quite there. But it really was, wasn't it? It all came together, and what we didn't see in the regular season became very apparent. Can you tell me about the growth of this team this year? How you grew?
Everyone knew that the team we were last year wasn't going to be the same, and the talent that we had, everybody had talent, so we just all had to mix it all together in order for us to become one and show it on the court.
Can I ask you about some other ladies that were so important to you? Davlin Brown had a great game out there today. Cheyenne Massey was all over the place playing well. Jalen Nascio, just a great bunch of seniors that you had this year. Can you talk about them?
I've been playing with them since my freshman year, and even our coach freshman year said that she knew this was the team. This was the team that was going to win a state title. And we did last year, and this year we proved it again that we are that team and we can do it again. And we've been playing with each other, we've been supporting one another, and we're just sisters.
Sholo came out, got the early lead. They led by 6 right from the get-go. They hit a couple of early three-point baskets. They got that lead. Was there ever any doubt in your mind?
No, we just knew that that's it. That's all they're gonna score, that's the run. And we're gonna step it up from now on.
Jenneth, you look around, you see all these great fans from White River, from the White Mountain Apache tribe that have come to support you. What does it mean to the community to get a championship like this?
It's very special to us because basketball is everything to our community. And we gave them hope, and we gave that hope right back to them with all their support and all their encouragement.
So what's next for you? What's down the road?
I think I'm going to go on and play some college ball.
Do you have some offers or anybody talking to you?
Yeah.
You want to say anything or?
No.
Keep that for yourself right now, right? Well, we want to hear about it when it happens. Don't forget the Northland Basketball All-Star Game that we do in June, okay? We'd love to have you a part of that. I know that you would be an automatic selection to play, so that's coming up first weekend of June, and we'd appreciate you considering playing in our game. Congratulations. We hope you enjoy this. This is very awesome.
Thank you.
Send some of your senior sisters over here, okay? All right, Janet, congratulations. The Sports Zone Radio's player of the game right there, Janet Sanchez. Janet! Sorry about that. I needed to yell because the radio guys next to us want to talk to Janet. What a great game. She is the player of the game. That's brought to you by White Mountain Regional Medical Center, everybody. What an afternoon. What a win for the Alchesay Lady Falcons as they continue to work, and now their head coach, Rick Sanchez, is up on the ladder, cutting down the final strings on the net. And whipping it around and getting more of a response from this group of Falcon fans. Amazing. Amazing finish and another big victory. Looks like that's going to be all of it for us right now, everybody. Looks like that's going to do it for our broadcast coverage of this girls 3A state championship. And a big congratulatory announcement for the Alchesay Lady Falcons. They win another state championship. But if you're the Sholo Cougars or a Cougar fan, don't hang your head. Christy Francis is doing great things as the head coach of that program. Let's hope that she continues on and will continue to be their leader. I think she's doing a marvelous job as Jazz Nosey is now displaying the trophy for the crowd. That is terrific. That's fantastic. We're about 15 minutes away from the start of the boys' game, by the way. Just to let you know, that's going to start at the top of the hour, 6 o'clock. And now the trophy is moving around. And Jaslyn Nosey is going to talk to KNNB about the victory today. So just congratulations all the way around for the Alchesay Falcons, for their head coach, Rick Sanchez. He's a quality guy. We love our interaction, our interfacing with Coach Sanchez. That's our final girls broadcast of the year. That is broadcast number 96. The 96th individual game broadcast for 2022-23 for Sports Zone Radio. That's the most ever we have covered in one season. Don't ask me how we did it. Don't ask me how we do it. Don't ask me how we recover when we do it, because it is an amazing grind. But the payoff is moments like this. It's unbelievable, and we're thrilled to be a part of basketball across the Navajo Nation and across the White Mountains. We call it Northland Basketball. That's our brand that we created as we travel countless miles across the Navajo Reservation and the White Mountains to bring you coverage of the best high school sports in the state. We love being a part of the best. That basketball up there is second to none. Now you get this White Mountains matchup in the championship game, which is completed, and a victory in a championship for Alchesay. We'll do our 97th game coming up in just a little bit. We cover the Monument Valley Mustangs in the boys' championship for the 3A. That game is coming up in a little bit. Monument Valley will take on Valley Christian. That's the number one seed, Valley Christian, and the number six seeded Monument Valley Mustangs. And all I got to say, all I can say is, wow, how about this, huh? How about this action in this activity? Make sure that the next time you're in town, you come on by Veterans Memorial Coliseum for some state playoff action. You need to be here, everybody. Final score, 52-35. Alchesay has defeated Sholo. The smoke machine is on. The Monument Valley Mustangs are coming onto the floor, and the Mustang fans are going to make some noise for them. We got that boys' championship on the way here in just a little bit. Game number 97 this season for the Sports Zone. Well, thank you, everybody. Thank you to the Arizona Interscholastic Association for the hospitality. Thank you to the NFHS Network for working with us, the Sports Zone, in the limited fashion we get to work with them during the postseason. Thank you most of all to you, outstanding fans, the best fans in the world, for being a part of what we do at the Sports Zone. It's our privilege to be able to provide coverage of these wonderful kids that we get to be a part of their lives. Wouldn't trade it for anything. And a big thank you to our producer, Derek Simmons, for his tireless work and all he does to make our coverage the best there is out there. Thank you to Derek Simmons. Want to also say a big thank you as well to a couple of guys that are working here on hand at the tournament, providing an assist here and there on different things. That acknowledgement goes to Dylan Nakadene. Thank you, Dylan, as well as Julio Kay, a guy who's joined us as the technical director. When we do live video, he's helping us in other ways today. So thank you, guys. We appreciate you profoundly. And by the way, the officiating crew. They got a great officiating crew for the boys' game coming up. I'm seeing Neil Yazzie right in front of me. I'm seeing Quinn Ashton from up in our neck of the woods as well, part of a three-man crew to call the boys' championship game coming up in a little bit. For the entire Sports Zone Radio and Simmons Media crew, my name is Floyd Simmons. Thanking you for joining us, everybody. Thanking you for being a part of what we do here. And signing off this broadcast of the Girls 3A State Championship game, a victory for Alchesay over Sholo. We'll see you for the boys coming up next. Thanks for being here. We'll see you next time. God bless you, and bye-bye for now.
This has been Northland Basketball, an exclusive presentation of Sports Zone Radio. Listen online at sportszone123.com and download the Sports Zone Radio app for your smartphone and listen wherever you go. Join us again for the next broadcast of Northland Basketball.